This event was sponsored by Spock, the Bootsy Lab for Beautiful Things, PSPDF Kit, with the JavaScript library you can view and annotate PDF files in the browser. Features include cross-browser support, mobile optimized UI, and no server-side component. Wild, a digital branding studio, they love GIFs, beer, and weird shit. x66 Lutz, the tech team, x66L Digital creates all digital experience for XXL Lutz, Möbelix, and Mömax all over Europe.
Hello, everyone. Yep, my name is Andrei Sitnik. Yep. I'm from Russia, St. Petersburg, and I'm with lead front-end developer in Evil Martians team. And yep, as he told, I'm creator of PostCSS, AutoPrefixer, and BrowserList. But like today is not a CSS conference, yeah? Today we are talking about JavaScript, so today talk will be different. So first, this is my Twitter. And I will post a slides with all links there like in next few minutes. So we are talking about different problem. This problem connected with JavaScript, yeah? Not so big as nuclear weapons, but very similar. You know, my family live in China. You know, like it's very important to visit your family, to eat borscht of your mother. And there is one problem. In China, Chinese internet, half of the packages will be lost, even if you are accessing like legal websites. Of course, like illegal websites, they are blocking completely. But if you are loading some data from like Western websites, half of the packages will be lost. This is a local company promotion by Chinese government. And it's very hard to use internet there. And you know, all my websites and maybe yours websites will have infinite loaders and all this problem of like broken internet. But you know, like China, who cares about China? Second world, not our my problem. But unfortunately, problematic internet is everywhere. There is no internet in New York metro trains, only in stations. Or for example, the you know .css in Paris, like .js, they have one of the best venues in the world. But unfortunately, without internet, without Wi-Fi, and very bad LTE connection. So yeah, if you have internet, it will be unstable. This is a rule. There is no stable wireless internet by like definition. And when we talk about offline, most of us think about like that offline, it's something like going to a mountain with all this like hiking and all the stuff. But it's not true. We should care about offline because we have every time 1 second, 2 seconds offline every day of our lives because like, no, shitty internet. And like, this is a slide from Nikita. He's the best. We're creating a website based on our local internet from our local client to our local server. And, like, it's perfect internet, but unfortunately, real internet looks like this. And nobody care about it. So we have a first problem. If we make a JACK request and we have a problem, like error in the middle of the request, nobody will care. User will see infinite loader. And you know, every user right now have a like rule, press the load button if you have any problem with web pages. It's not like a stable web ecosystem, yeah? If we all have these problems. Or for example, you press a save button, but you can't continue to work. You must wait until all these loaders. And like we have loaders on every step of our websites. It's not so good for users because these loaders we have it only for very small probability of error. But like most of the requests, fine, very good. And my favorite problem, and I think nobody cares about it, me too. Like I have the same problem in my websites. So we have a server with two fields, and one user load a form, change one field. Second user change a second field, but they load page in same moment, and then they save like parallel. As a result, because we all our JavaScript sent a final state, one user will overwrite state of the other users. Yeah, but we don't care. Like it's not our problem. But unfortunately, right now every website have at least two users because you have a mobile, and every user could open your website from laptop or from mobile. But you know, this is a current world, and we like don't care about it. But when I go to sleep, I always dream about the better world. I dream a world when every website, like not a special application like chats, but like regular websites, will have let update out of box without pressing reload button. We'll have optimistic UI out of box, like you save, you press a save and it will sync your state in the background. And we'll have a real offline first. Not that offline that just cache data, but that allow you to change data. And without extra code. Yeah, like it's like silver bullet. And with the current ecosystem. So like, you know, if you go into DevOps and ask them to replace database from like PostgreSQL to something like with a version 0.1.999, they will kill you. So this is my dream, to have a good networking for everyone. To be honest, there is no solution for this dream right now. But this is a reason why I create LogAx, to be closer to this dream. I'm not close this right now, but maybe in the future somebody will create a solution. So main problem is Ajax. It's very easy in the beginning, like on the conferences when people told you about Fetch API. But when you make it real work, it becomes more complex. So we need to kill Ajax. We need to change a way how we think. Right now, we are thinking that we have a client side with our JavaScript and, I don't know, rest of the world that we don't care, like servers, other clients. But there is a better way to think about it. It's called distributed system. It's the idea that all components of our website is connected. So we need to bring distributed system to everyone. Unfortunately, distributed system a little complex. This is not what we dream of when we go into front-end. We saw that it will be just a CSS. But unfortunately, right now, JavaScript is very complex. So we need to reduce complexity. How? Frameworks. Frameworks reduce complexity. Like, do you remember how painful it was to create single page application before the React? Do you have nightmares about it? Yeah, you know it. The same with Rails. All these frameworks change a complexity. So we need frameworks. But to create a framework, we need to understand what is, we need to think how, like frameworks. Frameworks, I believe, that framework is not the code. Like framework is not the Facebook slash React on the GitHub. Frameworks is the idea. Like the idea of Ruby on Rails is getting real. And if you understand this, if you accept this idea, you will have the completely same framework, the completely same code. Same with React and same with Redux. So we need an idea. And we found this idea in St. Petersburg when we drink with Dan Abramov. We talk about an interesting problem. You know, I told you about this problem number 3. Like we only have two users change one document and send this to a server. And server must take care about the conflict. And if you don't understand what does it mean, it's very hard to write algorithms to fix the conflicts. But if you can't, if your algorithms become too complex, it means that you need to change data structures. So let's change the data structure of our documents. And there is a way called event sourcing. Again, it's not my idea. We send to the server not the state, but the actual actions of the users. For example, this is an initial state that like server set a post title, set a likes number, but then one client remove one likes. And other client change a title. So to merge this, to fix this conflict, we doesn't need algorithm at all. We just need to concatenate errors and sort them again. That's all. And on top of this idea, CRDT was created. CRDT, it's data types, conflict-free replica data types. They have a lot of limits. They are not a silver bullet. But if you agree with all these limits, you will have a data types without any conflicts. Of course, with inside these limits. And the best implementation of CRDT was written, like the best implementation is WormJS, written by mad Russian scientist Viktor Grishenko. You can find him on the ReactiveConf. And when we talk with Dan about all these technologies, we found that there is one problem. Like we have like CRDT based on top of event sourcing, and it has a list of the actions log. But also Redux have a list of the actions, and also like a lot of our custom code have a list of the action. Even GraphQL have actions. We have actions everywhere, and then we need to put a very complex connection between all these histories. And so this is how IDEA was created. Let's create a single log for every history users, for synchronization, for Redux, and for like all creepy stuff, including QCRDT. So what is the idea? What is the idea of Logax? On the client side, we have same actions as Redux. Everything's the same, same ecosystem. And we have same actions on the server, like Redux on the server. And then we need to do simple things. We need to open a WebSocket, and every new action send this action to a server via WebSockets. When client lose a connection and connect again, it will be very easy to synchronize this log of the list of the actions, because every action have a number. So server could say, send me actions after number 4. And also, server could send server actions to a client, not one way, two way. And also, other client could create action, send it to a server, and then server to your client. So we have a left updates out of the box. And again, because a distributed system, we care about different client. And when you open website on the top, browser top, it will be a second client connected to this client, and they will synchronize states, not from the server, but between each other. So the idea of Logax, that you put action to the log and forget about it. You should not care about when and how it will be sent to a server. Just put it to a log and update your state, update your user interface. Instead of making a loader, you update interface immediately, right after you put action to a log. Logax will have a special package to show synchronization process, warnings or like notifications. But also, like if we have optimistic UI, if we change interface immediately after user save document, we have a problem with errors. What if we will say this to a server, we have error? In this case, in Logax, you can't send undo action. And client in any moment could remove action from the history and update the state as there was no action in the history, like in Soviet Union. This is the idea. So how it is implemented? Details. You know, idea is very easy. I can speak anything, but when you start to implement it, it starts tricky. So the first problem, in every event source system, the order is highly important. If you will have a different order of same actions on different machines, this time you should run away from your work because it's an unfixable problem. It's easy just to remove everything and start again. It's very bad problem. So we need to sort our like error of action by some field, for example, time. Unfortunately, time is not so easy when it's distributed. There is no ideal distributed time across any machine. There is a lot of limits. For example, if you create two times, they sometimes could be equal, because like this is how it works. Or if you create two times, sometimes next timestamp will be lower than the previous one. Because like this is a machine. Welcome. The reason is time synchronization process. In any moment, time could be changed, like corrected, and so it could be less. For example, in leap second problem, every year we have a special 1 second to finish all our work that we did not finish it for this year. It's a leap second.
Not every year,
but like yeah, sometimes it could be removed. And, for example, sometimes client who could have more than 1 hour difference from a server, like timestamp, we use timestamp here, it's time zone free time. The problem is because many users, when they go to a different place, idea of time zones is so complex, so they just change a time, actual time on the machine. It's very easy case. So we can use a vector clock. Unfortunately, vector clock is not so easy. Because in vector clock doesn't work very nicely in offline, especially it's long. And also vector clock is doesn't connect it with the real world. And I try to create logax for every developer, not for special distributed system specialists. So logax time is complex. I just burned my brain when I created it. So it uses timestamps, it uses unique node ID, and also special sequence number that increase if two time have the same timestamps. Also, server send a current time to client, and client calculate a time difference between a server and a client, and apply this time difference to any action. So any actions is in this machine time. Yeah, so logax time is nice, use it. Second problem. Okay, so it was happens just in a few weeks before the first logax introduction in React London. I was like very stressful about all this talk preparation, code writing, and then I found like if I will open two websites, same website on a in two browser tab, they will use the same storage because indexed database is the same for every browser tab with same domain. But when this browser tab will connect it to the one server, when this server will send two equal actions to both clients, one client will be the first, and second one will think that it is duplicate and ignore the action. And you know, it was disaster. I was just, no, 2 weeks. But sometimes you can put your problems into your benefits. So in logax, browser tab will elect a leader. And only this leader will have a connection to the server. And the followers will have actions from the leader. Of course, you maybe want to ask me, what if I will close the leader tab? It's not a problem. Leader always send a pings to our followers, and when leader will be dead, they will start a re-election. It's a simplification of Raft algorithm, but like more simple. So finally, we will have a same notification count in every browser tab. Like, but it was the ideas. Now reality. So show me the code. So logax is logax Redux front-end library. It's just 12 kilobytes, thanks for the size limits, with including Redux. And it's compatible to Redux. All you need is just replace a create store to like connection lines. It has a, but with logax, you will have, of course, the same dispatch method, but also will have a two additional magic methods. One method, crosstab, and one sync. So crosstab action, put the action into the indexed database and notify all browser tab about new action. So like to be on every browser tab. The most important is sync action. This action will be synchronized with the server. In some moment in the future, you should not care about it. You just put it into the log and forgot about it. It will be synchronized. So instead of making ajax request, you just put action with the sync method. Here is the problem. Unfortunately, it's not compatible with PHP and Ruby. You must have Node.js server using a special logax server framework. In this framework, you have a callbacks for every actions happens on the client. Of course, with that access and with process callback. In this callback, you can do anything that you want. You can use any database that you want, like PostgreSQL, MySQL, or for example, some fancy GAN.js database. And also, if you have already legacy PHP backend, you can make a HTTP request to them and make logax server as a proxy. And in any moment, you can add action to the log and send it to clients. Or to undo any clients. On any action on the clients. Data access happens by the subscriptions. You have a subscribe decorator, very similar to GraphQL decorator, and you put it around your component and say the channel that you need for this component. and make a on the server when somebody will subscribe to new channel, you create some actions for this client to initialize the state. But yep, this is how it works in the code. It was really vodka, by the way. I just put it because to hide Russian words. So, but trade-off. There is no ideal library. There is no silver bullet. First, it's not a CRDT. It's not a database. It's a framework to make both. Second problem. I told you a lot of good words how easy is to add something to the log. But unfortunately, in any event sourcing library, the real problem how you will clean your log from something you add. And it's not so easy in Legacy. Second problem, complexity. Like, software developer is not about using fancy libraries. It's not about using React or something. Informational technology programming is about controlling the complexity to choose a more simple solution, to not using complex solution for a simple case. Unfortunately, in Lagax, it's a framework and you take care about it, it's complexity. And as I mentioned, cleaning is a very complex thing. So don't use Lagax for simple websites. But if you have a nightmares every night about your networking, if you have a problem with it and you need to talk with someone, there is a good way, there is a good reasons to use Lagax. And the third problem, yeah, it's a 0.2 version. Very, very young project. Not so young, because we use it in our production. Don't repeat it. Don't use it in your big productions. We just have very brave managers. Technically, they don't have a choice. And like Lagax is not one-man project. We have a lot of contributors from around the world. So it's OK to use it in pet projects, but not in the production with the real money. So Lagax. Lagax, it's a thing to replace AJAX request and RESTful. Replace it with a different idea when you have a log and you put a REST action to this log and forget about it. Lagax will synchronize it. In the background, you should not care about it. You should not think about it. And you can use it to any web application. Not for like special real-time application like chat, for any application when you have a form and Brave managers. Why? Because you will reduce a lot of code. Because you just need to put action inside a log and forget about it. You don't need sagas. You don't need all this creepy Redux system. And your interface becomes faster because you don't need to think about all these loaders. You don't need to write it. And user will not see it. Everything will be much faster because of the optimistic UI. And of course, left updates of free, offline first, Redux API, all this stuff. Yep. That's all. So ask me a question when we will have a break. This is Twitter of Lagax. This is my Twitter when we start, will be soon. And my company when I'm working Twitter. Yep, that's all.